May the Archon of Rebirth watch over you. We are heading into the monolith. Once inside, we won't be coming out until Makros is finished. We will arrive in the Earth Realm, the lowest level of the monolith interior. This is the Earth Realm, where our adventure begins.
Point me towards this watchtower.
I'll guide you on your path, but keep your sword close. You'll find no friends here. These Twilight beacons mark places where we can start future missions. Let's activate as many of these as we can. lost Valorian artifacts will help you grow stronger. The watchtower is up ahead. Keep your hand on your sword. Target. is on the upper level of the watchtower. Gone far. Track his men. They'll lead you to him.
Hand it over if you want to live.
Macross has gone mad.
Thank you.
Well done. We have the rites of ascension. I'll study this spell and learn its secrets. But I cannot fight Makros and his army. That job is yours, and yours alone. Are you ready to see what you are up against?
Show me my enemies.
Makros, he's not a god yet. Tell me how the rites of ascension work.
In order to complete the rites, Makros will need to absorb a massive amount of Aetherium.
I doubt he's gathering all of that energy on his own.
Exactly. Each of his lieutenants is channeling elemental energies for him.
They'll be his strongest allies.
Without a doubt. But remember, when you defeat them, their strength will become your own. This is Zamora the Farseeing. Her Vargul warriors hold the Earth Realm for Makros.
She's a powerful sorcerer.
She's an animal, fighting to survive. She's sealed herself in her lair behind the Prismatic Falls. You'll have to find a way to breach her defenses. Next, you'll face Lunara. It's in the Water Realm, drawing magical energy from beneath the surface.
Lunara is a guardian construct. It won't be easy.
Lunara is mindless, but still dangerous. Unfortunately, its participation in the rites has only made it more powerful.
I recognize this one. Greaves Sunsteel.
Greaves is a godsmith and a madman. He is responsible for arming most of Makros' elite warriors.
He is also a master of fire magic.
He only serves Makros because it benefits himself. Lastly, Gildan Commander, a true believer in Makros' right to become a god. He holds court in the Air Realm, forcing trials of combat on unwilling souls.
I don't know this one.
Macross sees him as your replacement.
Killing his lieutenants isn't enough. I have to face him.
Macross absorbs the Aetherium they send him. He believes he is already unstoppable.
He's wrong. I'll stop him.
You are strong, Auron, but not strong enough to defeat Macross and all of his men. You must train. I've found a man who can help. He is a godsmith of some renown who can help you craft and upgrade your gear. Strangers are not well-liked by the Vargul, you least of all. They will attack you on sight. Those totems are full of magic. Smash them, and that magic can be yours.
Thank you.
part of my training.
You are always training, Auron. There's an Ethereum seal over the fortress gate.
Tell me our options.
I can shatter these magical barriers if we are able to gather enough power. Head to the base of the Prismatic Falls. There is a source of rich Ethereum there we can use.
You see what I see.
I am housed within your balance sheet. I can affect the world through you.
Thank you.
The Godsmith is in the caverns behind the fortress.
He'll be glad to see us.
Thank you.
he's back through there.
Thank the Archons. I thought I'd be stuck here.
Wait. Orin?
You're alive!
Xenon, I didn't know it was you here.
And I didn't know you were still alive. I'll take this as a sign. Perhaps we'll survive Macross's madness after all.
Come, we have much to discuss.
Are we going into a sanctum? Oh, Orin.
The armor of Phocas was most commonly worn by younger warriors seeking to hone their skills.
So this is the inside of a sanctum.
Mm-hmm. She's quite something. Though I did not expect her to be so independent.
She's a living being, Orin. Not merely some weapon to be wielded.
Well, in that case, I'll have to look to you for the weapons.
Ha! You never change. I'll provide you with basic arms. The rest we can forge. Here, this will help.
A sacred flame.
Go on. Light the forge with it.
You'll be able to upgrade. upgrade your equipment once we gather the right materials.
It's good you found Xenon. He'll be useful.
He's also a friend of yours.
We're at war. You and I only have time for those we find useful.
Perhaps. Usefulness comes after care, Auron.
What I care about is defeating Makros. If Xenon can help us do that, so much the better.
From an Earth sigil we acquired at the Vargal Fortress, I've been able to locate Zamora the Farseeing. She's at her lair behind the Prismatic Falls. You need to acquire enough Earth sigils, including the one we already have, before we can enter her lair. You can earn them by completing hunt missions here in the Earth Realm.